Hi everybody, it's Sharon. Welcome back to my channel. This video is a review on some of the glitters made by Glittertastrophe. She has her own business of selling hand-mixed glitters, and she asked me to do a review on some of her collection. So I hope you enjoy this video. I will have all of her information listed below for you, and sit back, relax, and enjoy. Okay, so I'm doing this swatch on a clear tip just because I thought that it would look really cool and I wanted to show you how to encapsulate the nail. So, and then I'll go through and I'll show you the swatches that I did. So I'm using, it's self-leveling, let me get this lid here. It's self-leveling clear gel by Cuccio, and it's their T3, and it's a hard gel. So if you were doing the natural nail, even if you had the clear tip on as an extension, or if you used a form and built out an extension, either way you want to make sure to prep the natural nail going through all of the steps. Since I'm using a nail tip, I just basically buffed it up a little bit, and then I did two layers of the gel just for the sake of time so that I could get a nice layer started. So now I'm going to go in with my third layer of the gel. I'm going to get a nice bead on there. And I already made sure that I kind of have my arch already done. So this is the layer that I'm going to be putting the glitter on. So I'm not really building anything here. I just want to get a nice even layer. Sorry if I keep going out of frame. I'm trying to see what I'm doing as well as showing you. Okay, and then I'm gonna put this in a UV light for 30 seconds and then I will be right back. Okay, so this is all cured and here it is. And then I'm going to use the glitter called Spoil Me, which is one of my favorites. And it's pretty much like a lot of pinks and golds in there. So you could do this a couple of different ways. Let me just get this out of the way. Get my brush out of the way. So you could dip the client's nail into the gel, which works that way. Or the other option is by using a brush and going on and patting the glitter on with the brush. So, you know, it's your choice, whichever method you prefer. And you just want to kind of either, now if you're doing a client, you don't want to do this back into your jar just for sanitary reasons. Since I'm just using this on a tip, I'm going to do it right back into the jar just so that I'm not wasting any glitter. But you just kind of want to go over it and brush it down. You're not really burnishing it in, you're just kind of making sure that the glitter is laying flat and getting any loose pieces off. And as I said, if you were doing this in a client, you would just do this over a paper towel. So since I'm doing it on the tip, I'm just doing it on there. So then you want to go back and put another layer of your gel on, which I don't know if I can, let's see. Yeah, I think I can squeeze everything in here. So you want to get a nice bead of gel. Glitter that was stuck to my brush, just to take that off. Okay, and then since this is self-leveling, I like to just let it sit for a few seconds and let it level out. And then I'm going to put this back under the light. And I'm going to do a second layer of glitter when we come out of the light. So I will be right back. Okay, so this is now cured. And again, we're going to do, you can either dip in or use your brush. Hopefully that doesn't happen to your client. Okay, we're having some technical difficulties here. We'll get that straightened out in a second. All right, so once you have your layer of glitter, you want to kind of do the same thing. You're sort of burnishing, but really just making sure that everything is laying flat and picking up anything loose. And then do your next layer of gel. Holding this on with my finger too, because the tacky stuff isn't really holding it, and I don't want to have it fly off with the gel on there. Okay, so I'm going to put this back under the light, and then I will be right back again. Okay, so once you have your layer on, you should be pretty satisfied with your glitter coverage. If you have any bald patches or anything, obviously you could do another layer of glitter. Now you just want to go in and encapsulate that with the gel, and you need to build up enough so that when you do your filing, you're not going to go through to the glitter layer. So I'm gonna do my first encapsulation layer, and I'm not trusting this right now, so I'm gonna hold on to this here. Yeah, you have major problems if that's happening on a client. Of course you wouldn't be using tacky wrap, so. So that's my first layer, and then we'll go ahead and cure that. So again, I will be right back. Okay, and now we're going to do another layer these you can actually just start painting on. You're not shaping anything. I mean, obviously you want to check the nail and make sure that you don't have one side thicker than another, so you would correct for that. And the other thing, I'm not sure, I don't think I said, but you want to make sure that you are putting the gel along your sidewalls and free edge. Okay. So now we want to cure that layer. I'll be right back. Okay, so I don't know if you'll be able to see. If I turn the nail to the side, and then look at it from the other angle. I'm not sure if it's picking it up on the camera or not, but there's a little bit of a dip. So it's right here. There's a little bit of an indentation. So I want to make sure that that's filled in. So it's a little bit, oh my goodness, I keep knocking over my camera. Okay, this is a lot harder to video than I thought it would be. So I want to show you how to correct this, but at the same time, I'm having a hard time with the camera angle. So you want to hold it so that you can see where you need to have more gel. And so you want to start there and then as I said, this is self-leveling, so you can kind of just spread it out from there, but you want to make sure that that one spot has enough gel in it so that it'll fill up and be even. So that looks pretty good. Get it out of camera just so that I can get a look closer. And that's something that, you know, you're going to want to do with your client, obviously. You want to bring the nail up so that you can see it from whatever angle you're checking. Okay, so once your nail is cured for that final time, you want to take alcohol on a lint-free pad and just wipe off the tacky dispersion layer. And then you can really feel how smooth the nail is and if where you need to file. So you could use an electric file if you have one. Gel is really soft, so just, you know, if you're using an electric file and you haven't used it with gel, just be very careful because it does file very quickly and you don't want to go into the layer with the glitter. So I'm just going to hand file just for the sake of the video. You just want to go in with some alcohol just to remove all the dust from filing. Okay, and then I'm just gonna go in with, I have Madame Glam Top Gel. So I'm just gonna put a layer of that on. bring out a nice shine. And again, you want to make sure that you kept the free edge. And then put that under your light for 30 seconds. So I'll be right back again. Okay. So I went ahead and wiped off the dispersion layer. And part of the reason why I wanted to do it on a clear tip was just to show you the underneath. I think it's really cool when you encapsulate and have it on a clear tip or on, like a gel extension or even acrylic. I just think that it's cool how you can see underneath, the glitter through. So I hope that this was helpful to you. And just to show you the other swatches that I did, and I'll have pictures of these as well, but I used, this is Madame Glam in the color Gold Digger. And I put that on this nail. And I used, this is Glitter of the Claw. And so I did that just on the tip of Gold Digger and then by itself so that you could see how it looked. And then on the next nail, I used Madame Glam in Girl Power. And with that, I used Spoil Me, which again, I think is my favorite, but I tend to lean towards pinks and purples. So I did it again on the tip of this one, and then I covered that whole nail. And then I used Madame Glam, in True Fire Brick Red. And Phoenix. And here it is on the edge of this nail. And then I covered this one. And then I used the same red. And I did Holiday Cheer, which is all very chunky glitters. And what I thought was really fun with the chunky glitters is you can really place them wherever you want and kind of, make a random pattern, or if you wanted to actually do a true pattern with that, you could. So that I thought was really cool about the chunky glitters. And this was, again, my review for Glittertastrophe. I will have her information running below as well as in the description box. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope that you learned something, and I will see you guys in the next video. Take care.